La suggerirò per il ruolo di Capò.
With his roots in showbiz, Silvio Berlusconi has always pursued what Italians call la bella figura, or making a good show of it. The G8 meeting, his third with hosting duties, is no different. But the scandal swirling around him this time beats all, even for Berlusconi. In an interview with CNN, Patrizia Diodario admitted being a high-paid prostitute and is now at the center of an investigation into whether Italy's prime minister paid for sex.
Io mi sento l'unica che è qui a dire cose che
I feel that I am the only one that is here telling the things that no other woman dare say.
Sono tutta spazzatura e quindi
Berlusconi has denied all charges. But as lurid pictures of parties at his lavish villa hit the papers, some are now questioning not just his judgment, but whether he's fit to leave Italy. The Economist magazine has always had an opinion on that. Mamma Mia was how it greeted his latest election victory. And still, its editors admit
a surprisingly large number of Italians find him rather charming and cheerful, and his brushes with the law they kind of almost sympathize with, because the Italian state is not highly respected by many Italians.
And what has been incredibly frustrating for both the opposition and his critics is that the more gaffe-prone Berlusconi seems to be, the more popular he becomes with Italians.
Mr. Berlusconi is a very tough man, especially when he's in the midst of a fight, and I think that he's going to be taking this G8 with the usual energy and enthusiasm.
But this larger-than-life personality is a tabloid dream. The incident's too rich, too long to catalog, but here's just one at the G20 with the Queen earlier this year. The Queen took a good-natured swipe at him, asking why he had to be so loud when calling out to President Barack Obama. To all this, Berlusconi recently told CNN he had never committed a gaffe.
Le gaffe non ne ho fatte alcune, nemmeno una.
I have never made any gaffes, not even one. Every gaffe is invented by the newspapers.
But as the cameras roll, it's clear that sometimes the newspapers don't have to invent a thing. Berlusconi has always done it his way. And even his enemies admit not even this scandal will likely get in his way. Calling it in CNN, Rome.